silhouette. Thoughts of nothing less. My chest is pressed as I attempt to cross this bridge you're building. Limitations take control. Show your cards and watch me fall. This paper heart is lost in fire, but I'm not burning. I'm not burning. I'm not burning. I'm not burning. Got a misty eye on you. Thought that all your lies were true. I stepped aside after countless times of hurting. You watched me stepping out the line. Emotion bottled up inside.
Murder. Sometimes it sets my teeth on edge. Other times, it feels tremendously exhilarating.
Vivid thoughts of metaphor. I climb for air, you dig your claws. Of course, I'm sure I'm way past the point of no returning.
In this world, there are people who are dark and incomprehensible.
That's alright, that's alright. I'm not burning.
And then there are those who have a certain superiority over others and should not limit themselves with the moral concepts of society. The only fate that every person equally shares is death.
Such teeth, dear, and it shows them pearly white. Just a jackknife has old Maggie Heath, babe, and it keeps it out of sight. You know when that shark bites with his teeth, babe, scarlet billows start to spread. Fancy gloves, though, where's old Maggie Heath, babe? So there's never, never a trace of red.
Nice swing. Hi, are you Chris Rose?
Yeah.
I'm Paul Murphy. I'm a private detective. I've been hired to investigate the suspected murder of Matthew Lyons.
Murder? I thought it was suicide.
That's what the police concluded when they closed the case. But we have reason to believe that someone had a motive to kill him.
Jesus. So how can I help?
I just need to ask you a few questions.
Yeah, sure.
What can you tell me about Matthew? How well do you know him?
Well, we were colleagues.
Friends?
Well, we went out with the boys, I did the clubs, but I wouldn't say we were close, no.
What kind of man was he? Where did he like to go? What did he like to do?
Well, cheekies, flannies, O'Shaughnessys.
Do you know any of his girlfriends?
Yeah, from what I hear, he had lots of them. I do remember Kat, though, and Laura, and Sally. Never made one stick, though.
Is there anything else you can tell me about Matthew?
Yeah, he liked to play golf.
Me too. All right, Mr. Rose. I'll let you go for now. Thank you.
Well, it's important that you know, though. I want to help in any way I can, so anything you need.
I understand.
Anything else come out about the case yet?
No. Not at the moment. Strange, though, isn't it? Yeah. One moment there's a guy walking about, going about his daily routine, work, playing golf. Next thing you hear, he's killed himself? Nah. There's no reason I can think of that he would. Thanks, Mr. Rose. Should work on that slice of yours.
Hello?
We have a problem. See, I've just spoken to a Detective Murphy and he...
I know.
How?
I persuaded Mrs. Lyons, Matthew's mum, to hire him.
What? Why?
Why the fuck not?
Oh, what are you up to, Hannah?
Just take a breath. We'll talk later. Shit. I ordered you some coffee.
I don't need your bloody coffee, Hannah. I just want you to explain yourself. I want to know why there's a detective investigating our crime. I want to know why you thought it was a good idea. I want to... Just explain yourself.
I wanted to turn our work of art into a masterpiece.
You're joking, yeah? It's too dangerous.
That's the point, Chris.
You're going to mess this all up for us. We killed a man. We killed a man that deserved it. It was perfect.
That wasn't enough. People need to know what we did. That's what'll make it truly perfect. You once said, nobody kills a man just to experience it. This takes it to the next step, because no killer would do what I did and flaunt their victims out in the open just for the thrill of it.
So all you want is for someone to tell you how bloody brilliant you are. Well, yeah, well done.
Because now we're both in danger, and you're going to fuck this up. You're going to fuck this up.
Oh, I see it going a little bit differently. I could always place the blame on you.
And how exactly are you going to do that?
I wanted to tell someone earlier. Chris insisted that I shouldn't. As the months went on, it got harder and harder. I was just lying to myself. I kept thinking, I'll forget about Matthew. I will forget about what Chris did to him. But I don't feel safe anymore. Chris has gone crazy. He's drinking more. He's beating me in the streets. It's like he wants people to see it. He wants to be caught. He wants to be punished for being the monster that he is, because he feels so guilty. Stop whining, Chris. Just play this out how I want it to.
You are fucking sick. You're twisted.
We said, murder is a crime for the privileged and should be reserved to those superior individuals. I am the butterfly, Chris. And you are just a desperate moth circling the flame.
February 16th, standing beside Brayford Pool, the police found Matthew's corpse. Reports says Matthew had some broken ribs. Internal bleeding. Cuts and bruising to the face, other parts of the body. Obvious signs of a struggle. Matthew was a strong build. It's taken a lot to take him down. Chris Rose. Seems clean enough on paper. Only been out of the country once. Barcelona. Keeps to himself. Pays his bills on time. But it all sounds a little too neat. A little bit too phony. I've seen drug dealers with the same kind of profile all the time. Sorry, you're going somewhere. I can always come back.
It's fine.
I'm Detective Murphy.
I know who you are. Come in.
I'd like to ask you a few questions. Regarding Matthew Lyons.
Do you want a drink, Detective? I'm going to make myself a coffee.
No. Thank you.
Just take a seat, make yourself at home. Excuse me, Detective.
I'm sorry. I was just, I became curious.
How long will this take?
I'm not sure. Why? Do you have something to be?
Nowhere important.
I've been hired to investigate the murder of Matthew Lyons.
How did he die?
That's what I want to find out. Were you and Matthew good friends?
No. He was my ex's friend. I was just fucking him.
Your ex being?
Chris Rose.
I see. How long were you and Matthew together?
About a month. It was never exclusive. I was still with Chris.
Did Chris know about you two?
No.
When was the last time you saw Matthew?
He was here the night before he left us.
You mean murdered?
Yes, I guess I would have to say that now.
Did you notice any strange behaviour coming from Matthew when he was here?
He tried a little harder, but that was about it.
What about Chris?
Chris has always been good in the sack.
No. I mean, any strange behaviour coming from him?
He was working a lot more. drinking more, but nothing unusual.
Is that why you split up?
No.
Anything to do with Matthew?
No. Do you suspect Chris?
I don't know.
Do you suspect me?
I don't know who to suspect.
Do you have any leads or theories?
I don't have all the answers yet. I wish I could come out with exactly what I think. But I can't. Not until I'm certain.
You married detective?
I was. Once. My wife, well, she died a long time ago.
And we have something in common. Both lost people in our lives. Now we're both alone.
Is there anything else you want to tell me?
I wish I could come out with what I know or what I think I know. But all I know is that I'm tired of being alone.
She didn't tell me anything.
She pointed you in the right direction though, didn't she? Sit down.
How did it make you feel? Having that man's life in your hands and taking it from him?
That was great. Oh, it was tremendously exhilarating.
Why did you kill him?
For the sake of it, of course.
Please, let me go.
You can scream now if you want to. We were above the moral concepts of society. See, we had this little plan that there were a few, select few, who should have the privilege to murder.
Who gave you the right? Who said you were better than anyone
else?
Come
on. The world's full of dark and incomprehensible people. In reality, people cannot change who or what they are. All we share, the only thing we equally share, is death.
Then let me ask you this. Who has the right to kill you?
Chance.
My mum died when I was 14. My dad was torn apart and he took it out on me. I couldn't take it anymore, so I left. And then I met Darren. He told me he loved me. Then he started pimping me. I had nowhere else to go. Something inside me just snapped. I seduced this guy. And he killed Darren for me, and I just stood there and watched him die. And that's when I knew I was nobody's victim. I would do to guys what they would do to me. Fuck 'em. Tell them I loved them. They're so pathetic, and it's so easy.
She was just using you. Same as she used me. She won't be doing it anymore, though.
Where is she?
You'll find her at the end of the film.
You should have listened. You were always the moth, and I was always the butterfly.